Welcome to today's video. What is up? Today we're going to learn how to fully control what our slider looks like. This slider isn't looking too good, but you can see that I pretty much control every single little thing about it. I change the height of the track, I change the color of the small division ticks, I change the overlay color right here to purple or indigo, I even change the color of the label and increase the font size. And I also made this thumb right here bigger and change its color. So stick around to learn exactly how to fully manipulate the look of your slider. So here we are in the official documentation, and if you scroll down a little bit, you eventually get to this part right here. And here it says to determine how it should be displayed, like colors, thumb shape, etc., you gotta use the slider theme data, which is either available from a slider theme widget or the themeData.slider theme. And it says right here too, you can also override some colors with the active and inactive color, which we've already used in the previous video. But like they say right here, for more fine-grained control of the look, you gotta use a slider theme data. So let's get to that. We're pretty much where we left off in the last video. And by the way, if you don't know anything about themes, you can click the video on the top right now, where I go over what exactly themes are and how they work and how to apply them. Also, something I forgot to mention in the last video, you can come to the slider here and make it a Cupertino slider, just like this. And I'm going to comment these out. And they're not applicable because the Cupertino slider is basically the slider that iOS users are used to seeing, and they don't really have labels or specific inactive colors. Basically, this is what it is. This is usually the inactive color. I'm pretty sure that all of their sliders have this inactive color. Now this looks way more iOS-like. And the best part about the slider widget is that you can just delete this and do slider.adaptive. And if we save, here it will show the Android version. But if this was an iOS emulator, then it would show the Cupertino slider. So if you're making an app for both Android and iOS, this is a really cool thing to know, but I'm just doing the Android version, so this isn't necessary. Now, how do we go about doing what was on the documentation? How can we transform this slider of ours into exactly what you saw in the beginning of the video, which was a 100% personalized slider? What you do is you come over here, and I'm going to hit Alt Enter for the action menu to pop up. And I'm going to wrap this with a widget, and it is the slider theme widget right here that you got to use. And as you can see, it expects the data property. And in the data property, you use a slider theme data. And now here is where the magic happens. Now, if I hit save right now, nothing happens because this right here holds all of the default information that the slider comes with. And if I hit control space here, you can see all of the different things that you can define right here. And this truly does give you a much better control over what the slider will look like. There's so many that I won't even be able to go over all of them. And pay attention to something. For example, the active track color is essentially the color of this bar right here, but not including the thumb, which is the circle right here. And if I come here and I do colors.black, for example, and I hit the save button, nothing changes, okay? Because the active color will always override whatever you have defined on the theme. So if we drop this right here, now the color changes and the thumb goes back to the default color because we haven't given it a specific color. And let me just go ahead and remove the inactive color as well. Now that's default as well. Let's make this deep orange. And now let's do the inactive track color. Let's make it colors.black. Hit the save. And now this is closer to what we had initially. Now let's change the thumb color right here. Let's make it colors dot, I don't want to make it too ugly, but I kind of want to show that we have all the control here, so maybe just this pink. Okay, that works for me. But let's do something cooler. Let's make the thumb, which is the circle right here, bigger than it is right now. And also, when I click it, you can see a little overlay thing going around it, and I want to change that color too. So let's do that as well. First, let's change the color, which is called overlay color. Let's give it something noticeable, like indigo maybe. Now there it is. It doesn't look as nice anymore because it needs opacity, which we can do very easily with the with opacity method. Let's give it a 0.5 and check out what it looks like. It looks better, but maybe it's a little bit too solid still. I'm just gonna give it 18, and now that's a nice overlay. Now to change the size of the overlay, we gotta use overlay shape, which takes a slider component shape, which in this case it's called round slider overlay shape. And here, as you can see, the overlay radius by default is 24, but we're going to change it to something crazy like 40. Oh, and my bad, I meant we're going to change the overlay size, not the thumb size. Not yet, at least. Now, if I click it, look how big that is. And now to change the thumb color, it's pretty much like the overlay shape, except it's thumb shape. And it takes the same type, slider component shape, except in this case, it's called round slider thumb shape. And once again, you can see the default value is right here. And what we care about is the enabled thumb radius, which is 10 by default, but let's make it 26 so we can really tell the difference. I'm gonna hit save on this, and that is way too big. We gotta make it smaller. Let's just make it 18, looking better, nice overlay. And now I'm not sure if you can see the small ticks right here, which are caused by the divisions. In fact, let me make less divisions. Let's make it 12. Now they're more separated, maybe you can see it. What you gotta do is use active tick mark color. And then let's make it, what is easy to see, an orange. I don't know, I'm gonna make it blue. Maybe that will work. Then I'm gonna hit save. And did you notice that? A small change. That's how you change those colors. And now if you wanna make the track height bigger, if you wanna make this larger, all you gotta do is track height and then give it a double, like 20, for example. That's a bit much. Let's make it 15, looking better. And as you can see, the ticks only show up to a certain height. If I do 18, it disappears. But if I do 17, you can see them. And now you can very easily see these ticks as well. So let's change the color of those two. Inactive tick mark color. Let's just make it white and save it. And boom. Now it might look really ugly, but we have full control over it. Let me just make it a little bit better, like 13. 11 is better. And now to finish this up, you probably want to style the little label that shows the values as you scroll right here. And that is called value. You can change the color, the shape, and the text style. I'm just going to change the color and the text style. I'm just going to make it red and the text style. I'm just going to increase the font size a little bit, make it 14, and increase the font weight, make it bold. I'm going to hit save, and if I drag it now, you see it's changed, but maybe the font needs to be bigger. It looks pretty similar. Let's just make it 18. And okay, now it's bigger, as you can see. You can literally make whatever slider you want. You have full control of the styling, like this. And in this case, you would do this method if you only had one slider in your app. If you had multiple, it wouldn't really make sense because you'd have to keep copying this and making this the data to each slider. So what you would do then is take this right here, copy it, come over here, and you would come to whatever theme data you got going on here, and they've got a property called slider theme, and you just use it right here. And let me just remove this widget right here, and then I'm going to hit save, and everything remains the same. So that's pretty much how it works. And this isn't limited to just sliders. You can come over here to the theme data class, and this link will be in the description. And if you just scroll a little bit and come over here to the constructors part, you can click the theme data and look at everything that you can change right here. But these aren't all themes. You gotta look for it. Just do this and it'll highlight it. For example, button theme data, toggle buttons theme data, text themes, icon themes, tab bar themes, card themes, app bar themes, dialogue themes. As you can see, there are a bunch of themes that you can predefine. And then whenever you apply the widgets corresponding to the theme, then it will look exactly like you want it already. And this can save you a ton of work. So I hope you were able to learn something today. If you were, please drop a like and subscribe for more Flutter tutorials. Thank you for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.